Very good morning, friends. Today we are going to consider the qualities of good researcher. It means that whatever required qualities are there for the good researcher, those qualities we are going to study in detail. Now try to understand what is the role of researcher in the research. That role you have to understand first. What type of functions he has to complete, what type of a duty he has to perform when he is going to conduct the research. It means that afterward definitely you will understand what type of qualities are essential for good researcher. Try to understand. Researcher is a central figure in research activity. Everywhere you will find researcher is at a central place in a research activity. The quality of research depends heavily on characteristics and qualities of researcher. It means that quality of research is essential. What type of qualities of research are essential? Those qualities we are going to consider here now. But the quality of research depends upon the characteristics and qualities of researcher. It is said that a bad tool turns out to be a good one if it is in the hands of good researcher. It means that bad tool can be converted into good if the such type of a tool is in the hands of good researcher. That's why quality of researcher is essential. Conversely, it is also true that however a good tool there may be, if it falls in the hands of the bad fellow, the results are disastrous. Try to understand. Results are disasters. Definitely those results may not be good. Okay, if there is a fortunate coincidence of good researcher having a good tool, one can imagine how wonderful the result would be. It means that both things are good, at that time you will get good results. Okay, you can get good result of the research work. Okay, according to Mr. Michael Foster, following are the qualities of good researcher. It means that different types of the qualities are essential for becoming a good researcher. What are those qualities? Those qualities we are going to study step by step. Okay, from this chart you'll understand there are different types of the required qualities. There are different types of the essential qualities to become a good researcher. Okay, and such type of a qualities also we have to understand. First quality is there, researcher must be truthful. Researcher must be truthful. It means the researcher is the seeker after the truth and hence must be truthful. Because he is a seeker after the truth and hence he must be truthful in responding or in reporting or in preparing his findings. Okay, researcher must possess the following qualities. What type of qualities he should have to possess? Okay, first, curiosity about unknown. He should become curious about knowing the unknown things. It means that researcher has to possess this quality. What is it? Curiosity about unknown. Then second quality is also given here, imagination and insight in the problem under study. It means that insights also he should have to know and imagination power also he should have to having. Okay, that's why imagination and insight in the problem under study, and this quality also he has to possess. Then another thing also we have to understand, desire for accuracy of observation. Whatever the observation he or she is doing, there should be accuracy in such type of observation. Okay, that's why this quality is also essential. Then desire for precision in statement. Your statement should be precise. Okay, your statement should be precise. That's why a decision should be precise. That's why desire for precision in statement. And the discipline, there should be discipline among the researchers. That's why first quality is there about the good researcher, that is a researcher must be truthful, and in this truthfulness these five elements are included. Okay, then second quality we have to understand here, he must be alert. researcher must be alert. The researcher has to be alert not only to his own needs. Researcher has to be alert not only to his own need, but also about the environment and the circumstances prevailing in the course of the research. By alertness, he can judge the persons. By alertness, he can judge the persons, he can judge the situations, and also he can judge the phenomena in a better manner. That's why he must be alert. This is the second quality for becoming a good researcher. Then next quality we have to understand, he must have moral courage. Moral. Researcher must possess a moral courage to face a sudden contingency. The courage for steadfast endurance. The courage to accept the conclusions that may not be matched with his own expectations. It means that conclusions may not be matched with his own expectations. Moral quality of the courage requires. Moral quality of the courage requires sound health, persistence, objectivity, tolerance, self-control, refined manners, adaptability, open-mindedness, decision making, and effective personality. What is it? Effective personality. It should be. In this way, he must have moral courage with the help of these different qualities. Okay? Then next quality we have to understand, he must be an able person. He must be an able person. To be an able person, he must possess the knowledge about research problem. He must possess the knowledge about research methodology. He must possess the knowledge about statistical techniques and also knowledge about presentation. In this way, this type of a quality is also essential. It means that what is it? He must be an able person. Such type of abilities should be in his, okay? That's why this quality also we have to understand. Then next quality we have to understand, he must have motivation and professional aspiration. He must be self-motivated person. Try to understand. Researcher must be a self-motivated person, ready to strive hard till he succeeds in his endeavors, despite all odd and contingencies. He should work with missionary zeal during the conduct of research. It means that such type of a quality is also essential. He must have motivation and professional aspirations. Okay? Then another quality also we have to understand. He should uphold the ethical values. Okay? Researcher should uphold the ethical values. Standard of research also depends on how well researcher follows the professional ethics. To do, he must accept the right of participation to remain anonymous. He must accept the right of respondents to maintain privacy. He must behave with the respondents in a responsible manner. And also he must accept the right confidentiality. All these things are required for becoming a good researcher. Try to understand. Then another quality also we have to understand. Other qualities includes different subtypes, subpoints. What are the following qualities are required there? Those qualities we have to understand. Experience and training. He should have sufficient experience about the research first. It means that he should have to know the research procedure. He should have to know the research stages. He should have to know the formalities for the research. Okay? It means that he should have such type of a particular experience. And also training is also there. Training should be for what purpose? For collection of the data, for analysis and interpretation of the data, for making the findings and conclusions and suggestions also. Certain type of a training is essential, and for writing a report also training is required. In this way, a training is essential. That's why experience and training, this is the first quality which is included in other qualities. Then knowledge about human psychology. He should have sufficient knowledge about human psychology. Suppose you ask cross question to these respondents at that time, how that person is responding to you. Such type of observation you should have to do. Okay, and for that purpose also, you should have to get a knowledge of human psychology. Then another quality is also essential there, interest and knowledge about phenomenon under study. Different types of the interest and different types of the knowledge about the phenomenon under study, and that is also required. And the last point I would like to explain here, knowledge about research techniques. There are different types of the research techniques, and about those techniques also researcher should have the knowledge, and that knowledge about different types of the research techniques. Okay, in this way these are the different qualities which are required for becoming a good researcher. Now next point I would like to explain here, what are the limitations of research? There are different types of the limitations of the research. Okay, research in commerce and management comes under the category of social research. It deals with social phenomena and human being which cannot be put to a laboratory test under guided conditions as in a case of psychological phenomenon. Following are the different main limitations, try to understand. Following are the different main limitations or difficulties in application of scientific method in science, social research. Okay, what are those limitations? Those limitations also we have to understand. In this chart, half dozen limitations I have mentioned here, I have given here. What are those? First limitation is there, complexity of science. What is it? Complexity of science, social data. Complexity of social data. What is it? The subject matter of social research in human behavior, which is influenced by several factors, which can be classified as economic, social, psychological, biological, environmental, cultural, and geographical. These factors are simultaneously affecting the human behavior. Don't forget at all. Hence, it goes beyond the research of the researcher. It goes beyond the reach of the researcher to analyze and study the impact of such various known and unknown factors on the phenomenon under investigation. That's why such type of a limitation you have to understand. What is it? Complexity of social data. Second limitation we have to understand, problem of interpreting cause and effect relations. Cause and effect relations. In case of social phenomena, cause and effects are interdependent. Don't forget it all. Cause and effects are interdependent. For example, poverty and illiteracy, price and demand, income and expenditure, all these aspects are interdependent. Try to understand. Hence, it is difficult to establish what is the cause and what is the effect between such variables. That's why such type of a cause-effect relationship is also you have to understand clearly, but there is a problem of interpreting cause and effect relation. Then next limitation we have to understand, dynamic nature of social phenomenon. What is it? Dynamic nature of social phenomenon. Human society is subject to continuous and rapid change. Hence, the conclusions and techniques of social research become obsolete very soon. Hence, the question arises, what is the utility of this studying a phenomenon which is continuously changing? Its conclusion and suggestions can hardly be used for improving the things in near future. Due to the dynamic nature of the social phenomena, our task of the analyzing data become complex.
एंड कंक्लूजन्स ड्रॉन आर रॉन्ग एंड इम्प्रैक्टिकेबल. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. बट द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डायनेमिक नेचर ऑफ द सोशल फेनोमेना इज सॉल्व टू सम एक्सटेंट बाय द स्टडी ऑफ लैग्ड वेरिएबल्स एंड फ्रेमिंग ऑफ डायनेमिक मॉडल्स. ओके, इट मीन्स दैट डायनेमिक नेचर ऑफ सोशल फेनोमेना, दिस इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ लिमिटेशन ऑफ द सोशल रिसर्च. देन नेक्स्ट लिमिटेशन वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड, प्रॉब्लम ऑफ मेंटेनिंग ऑब्जेक्टिविटी कंपेयर टू द अदर टाइप्स ऑफ द रिसर्च. फ्रेंड्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, कंपेयर टू द अदर टाइप्स ऑफ द रिसर्च इट इज मच मोर डिफिकल्ट टू बी ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड इम्प्रैक्टिकल और इम्पार्शियल एंड अनबायस्ड इन सोशल रिसर्च. The main research, main reason for the problem of maintaining objectivity is due to the fact that usually social researcher himself is the member of society which he studies. Therefore, it is natural that his own attitude and orientations are determined by these same social causes that he wants to study. The biases likely to occur in social researches are bias of observers, the bias of informer, bias due to the defective samples, defective questionnaires, defective data collection, defective analysis, and defective generalization. Such type of a limitation we can understand here. For example, people with socialistic and capitalistic outlook have totally contradictory ways of looking to the events. Former look. In order to minimize the above mentioned factors, the social scientist must employ strictly the scientific method in research. It means that such type of limitations also we have to understand. Then next limitation is their predictability. The researcher in physical science enable the predictions of future trends and events. The laws of physical sciences are universal and true for all types, under given circumstances. But the social sciences research become of complexity of the social data and simultaneous effect of innumerable variables on human behaviors. The future events or trends cannot be predicted precisely. Only a rough estimation about the social phenomena can be made. That's why unpredictability, this is also one of the limitations of the research. Then next limitation we have to understand, difficulty in verification of inferences. There is a difficulty, definitely. You cannot verify the inferences clearly. The results of physical sciences research can be verified by repeating the experiment. It means that with the help of the experiment, we can verify the result of physical sciences. But in social sciences, this is not possible. In social sciences, such type of a verification of inference drawn cannot be done as a social event or non-repetitive. Human behavior is continuously changing and tools of research are inadequate. Okay, that's why there is a difficulty in verification of inferences. This type of a limitation also we have to understand about the research. Next limitation we have to understand, difficulty in use of experimental method. Human being, which is a major element of the social research, try to understand. Human being, which is the major element of human research, cannot be put to laboratory test. Even if it is done, the responses of human beings would not be natural, try to understand. They would be biased due to the awareness of the artificial conditions. Hence, the social researcher has to watch them in the open world and wait for circumstances to occur in natural world. In this way,
this limitation also we have to understand. What is it? Difficulty in use of experimental method. Then next limitation we have to understand. What is it? Difficulty in quantification of variables. Each and every phenomena cannot be quantified. It means that there is a difficulty in quantification of variables. Okay. Precision in research depends upon effective use of quantitative methods and techniques. But most of the factors involved, try to understand, most of the factors involved in social science researches, okay, are qualitative, which cannot be quantified. For example, we cannot measure the social concepts like urbanization, cultural changes, consumer satisfaction, political interference, etc. We can have only rough estimation of these concepts. It means that this is also difficulty. This type of difficulty of quantification of variables we have to understand. Next difficulty we have to understand, difficulty in control of variables. Try to understand. During the laboratory experiments carried out in physical research, the interrelationship between two variables is studied to establish cause and effect relationship. By keep or others, related variables constant by controlling them artificially. But during social research, which is carried out in open society, the artificial control of the other variables is not possible. Hence, difficulty arises in establishing the cause and effect relationship with precision. And this type of also limitation we have to understand. Then next limitation we have to understand, limited finance. In the word of the professor God and Head, the rate of progress in social sciences is much less than the rate of progress in physical branches only due to financial lack. It means that there is no sufficient financial provision for the research work in social sciences. Professor Michael has also pointed out that a qualitative research hardly requires any equipments. Try to understand. Qualitative research hardly requires any equipments beyond few books and hardly any helper except a typist. A quantitative worker need often statistical laboratories, crops of computers, and sometimes a staff of the field worker. Thus, social researcher normally has limited resources at his disposable compared to a research in physical sciences. It means that limited finance is there for social sciences, and such type of limitation is also there. And the last limitation we have to understand, what is it? Problem of interdisciplinary research. Every social phenomenon is influenced by number of social, economic, political, and cultural factors which are interwoven. Okay, hence a social researcher finds it difficult to isolate them. The main problem in interdisciplinary research is that every branch of knowledge has its own approach and own methodology suited for the purpose when these are tried to be fitted in single frame. Okay, and this type of limitation is also we have to understand. It means that in short, social research is less precise in its findings compared to physical research because of its numerical limitations, such as the complexity of social data, inadequate tools of analysis, lack of control over variables, human bias, dynamic natures of social phenomena, and limited resources. However, such type of research towards use of scientific method and tools is fast growing in social sciences. As a result, in near future, there will be more accuracy and refinement in social research like physical science researches. In this way, these are the 11 types of the limitations of the social research. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.